இங்கிலீஷ் குயின் உறவுகள் அனைவருக்கும் அன்பான வணக்கம். நம்மளோட சேனல்ல அமரர் கல்கி எழுதின பொன்னியின் செல்வன் நாவல் தொடர்ந்து வந்து நீங்க ஆங்கில பதிவுல கேட்டு வந்துகிட்டே இருக்கீங்க. கடைசியா பார்த்த பதிவு சாப்டர் 3ல நம்மளுக்கு முடிஞ்சிருக்குது. இன்னைக்கு நம்ம அதோட தொடர்ச்சி சாப்டர் 4 பார்க்கலாம். சாப்டர் 4 த கடம்பூர் பேலஸ். லெட்ஸ் ஸ்டார்ட் ரீடிங். வந்தியத்தேவன்ஸ் ஹார்ஸ் had a good rest while he was in the temple. The horse was now hyperactive. It reached the gates of the Kadambur palace in less than half an hour's time. Chengannar Sambuvarayar was one of the important chieftains of Chola kingdom. The opulence of his palace reflected his high rank. The entrance of his palace looks like the fortress at the gates of a city. The walls on both the sides of the main entrance looked like the walls of a fort. And, as in a fort, the walls turned and stretched for the entire perimeter of the palace. The entrance was bustling with activity. There were a number of elephants, horses, and bullocks. There were a lot of people attending to the animals. Some were trying to harness them, some were feeding them, and some were trying to make the animals drink water. There were a number of light boys too, men who held flaming torches so that the others could do their work. And those light boys had their assistants, those who constantly monitored the flame and poured oil on them when they were about to go off. Vandiyathevan was a little hesitant to go further. They are planning something big for tonight. Maybe I should not have chosen this day to visit my friend. Another part of his mind was curious to know about the events scheduled for the night. The gates of the palace were wide open, but they were guarded by a number of soldiers armed with sharp, shining spears. They appeared like the security guards at the gates of the palace of death. If Vandiyathevan hesitated at the gates, they were sure to stop him. The best way to gain entry was to just gallop past the gate, unmindful of the guards. He put his plan to action, but the soldiers were smarter. They blocked his way with their spears. Four soldiers came near the horse and held its reins. One of the four looked pointedly at the visitor. Meanwhile, another soldier brought a flaming torch to examine the stranger's face in better light. Vandiyathevan feigned anger as he spoke. "Is this your way welcoming the royal guests? Blocking them at the gates? Oof! You need not have invited me at all. Who are you, impudent fellow? Where do you come from? And what do you want?" "You want to know about me? I come from Tiruvallam, a town in Vanapadi kingdom. There was a time when the soldiers of your country would tattoo the names of our ancestors on their broad chests. They considered it an honor. My name is Vallavarayan Vandiyathevan. Can I go in now?" "Not so fast, young man. If your clan is so famous, why can't you in the least offer a herald to talk about it?" The other soldiers laughed. Meanwhile, the head of the guards came near the prince. His words were menacingly firm. "Whoever you may be, you can't enter the palace now. All the guests invited for the day's event have already come. We have strict orders not to let anybody else in." Seeing the ruckus happening at the gates of the palace, a few soldiers came running to the place. "Hey man, look at this horse. This is the same one we drove into the crowd on the banks of the lake. Don't say horseman, it's just a decorated donkey. Look at the man sitting on it. Why is he so stiff? Oof! Vandiyathevan heard these words. A plan had formed in his mind. He cleared his throat and spoke to the head. Okay, leave the horse. Let me go back. The soldiers, who had been holding the reins till now, let it go. Vandiyathevan gave a distinct pressure on the horse belly with his legs. At the same time, he unheathed his sword and swirled it menacingly at the gods. It appeared as if the great Mahavishnu was wielding his weapon, the golden disc. The horse leapt forward into the palace. The soldiers blocking the way fell down. The spears clashed against each other and fell on the ground. The horse jumped on those mean creatures who tortured it a little while ago. The soldiers, who never expected the sudden attack, fled in all directions. So many things happened at the same time. The large doors to the palace were banged shut. Catch him! Thief! Enemy! They all shouted. Spears clashed with swords, creating a deadly clattering sound. A huge drum sounded, dum, 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 to proclaim danger. Vandiyathevan's horse was surrounded by armed soldiers. First, there were only a few. Soon, there were about 50 soldiers armed with deadly weapons. Vandiyathevan jumped down from the horse. While defending himself with his sword, he shouted, Kandamara! Kandamara! See, your men are trying to kill me! As soon as the soldiers heard the name of their master, they froze. They moved away from Vandiyathevan. Meanwhile, a voice thundered from the palace balcony. Stop! Stop it, I say! What's happening there? Lord, a stranger tried to pass through the gates and he is calling our prince by his name. Kandamara, go there and find out what's happening. The balcony voice thundered again. The thundering voice belonged to the owner of the palace, Thenganar Sambuvarayar. What is the problem? This voice was very young. The soldiers stood away in respect. A young man came running. He looked at Vandiyathevan, who was still swirling his sword menacingly at the soldiers. Is that you, my dear friend? Is that really you? The voice was very emotional. The young man ran up to Vandiyathevan and held him in a tight hug. What happened actually? Who is this Kandamara? We'll see in next part. Okay friends, thank you so much for listening this episode. I meet you soon with Chapter 4, Part 2. Always be connected with English Queen's Tamil Info and Blogs. Thank you.